Today we're looking at a question from one of our viewers. D.A. Janau, not sure how to pronounce that, says he's a vegetarian, works out a lot, but his cholesterol still runs a bit high. We get this question once in a while, so a couple pointers on that. There are several determinants of our serum cholesterol levels. The amount of cholesterol in our food is one of them. A vegetarian diet can be higher or lower in dietary cholesterol. Depends how it's put together. But a bigger determinant of our blood cholesterol levels is the amount of saturated fat in our food. Now, plant-rich diets tend to be lower in saturated fat, which is why they also tend to lower cholesterol levels. But there are exceptions. Tropical oils, like coconut and palm oil, are very high in saturated fat, and they raise LDL cholesterol. So keep an eye on highly processed foods like imitation meats. I'm not saying it's the case of this viewer specifically, but I've seen people start to eat a lot of these foods and their lipids jump up, even on plant-based diets. Also, coffee, especially unfiltered coffee, can raise cholesterol. It's not a huge effect, but good to know if you're fine-tuning. Number two, assuming all the dietary factors are under control, yeah, genetics matters. Diet does a lot, but it's not magic. We know there are genetic factors that keep cholesterol higher in some people. So if that happens to be your case, don't feel guilty about it. There's a limit to how much we can do with lifestyle. Number three, cholesterol is important, but it's not the only factor. The decision to start a cholesterol-lowering drug, like a statin, also considers family history, diabetes, smoking, etc., together with how high your cholesterol is. Now, he says he has good blood pressure, healthy BMI, etc. So that's good news. Number four, it's good to bear in mind cholesterol is a good indicator, but the real key to cardiovascular risk is the number of cholesterol carriers in our blood, called lipoproteins, which we can measure with something called ApoB. Now, in about 25% of people, give or take, cholesterol can be a bit high, but ApoB can be normal, and those people are not at higher risk. So if you've done a lot of troubleshooting on lifestyle and your cholesterol numbers are still not quite where you want them, consider taking a look at ApoB. Talk to your doctor. Last, a word on statins. Starting a drug is, of course, your choice. If your doctor advises you to do it, definitely consider it. If you're not sure about it, talk to another specialist. Get a second opinion. Get a third opinion. Like any medication, statins have potential side effects. So I don't think we should be adding them to the drinking water. But for people who are at risk, the benefits of statins far outweigh the risks. There's a notion in some online circles that plant-based diets are magic and they eliminate the need for all drugs in any situation. That is not true. I'm a big believer in diet. A healthy diet can lower your disease risk. But drugs have a time and a place. For the right people, they definitely help and they can save lives. Also, if the statins don't agree with you for some reason, there are other classes of cholesterol-lowering drugs that are very effective. Your doctor can work with you on that. By the way, I don't prescribe statins. I do research full-time, and I have no lost love for big pharma, so I don't have skin in the game. I'm just giving you the facts as I see them. You have every right to decline a drug, of course. My suggestion, my recommendation, is that you carefully weigh the pros and cons based on high-quality information before you make a final decision. If you have other questions on health or any aspect of nutrition, write them below. We'll try to keep making these shorter videos about once a week. See you next time. Be well.